Hi, I'm Mark Cashman, and I'm on the Microsoft 365 marketing team, primarily focused on SharePoint and OneDrive, and here today to share with you what you can do with SharePoint inside of Microsoft Teams. When we work together and get things done, there should be less confusion between people and the content that they share. High-performing teams achieve more with fewer open questions among well-informed team members. At Microsoft, our mission is to empower every person and organization on the planet to achieve more. And when this is done together as a team, it's teamwork that moves things forward. Your intranet in Microsoft 365 is ready for you, built for teamwork to keep you and your team informed, engaged, and moving forward. This is the design goal behind Microsoft Teams and the reason why SharePoint is deeply integrated to provide great content experiences and services for teamwork right within your hub. And with this knowledge, people work confidently, knowing everything is protected by industry-leading security and compliance and the ability to adhere to your desired governance outcomes. To show you all of how this works, I will highlight four main benefits of SharePoint Plus Teams through several scenarios, with helpful tips and tricks for you to see on full display. To start, I will show you how to work on files when you're in Microsoft Teams. We are providing a new files experience to give you more powerful options with how you view, sync, and share your files when working with your peers in a Teams channel. Here are three example scenarios. So one of the main default tabs in a Microsoft Teams channel is the Files tab. And this Files tab is backed by the power of SharePoint, giving you these great files experiences and content services. To highlight that, when you go to a channel, this is the general channel of the Mark 8 project team. I click on Files, and I see all the files that are available to me, particular to this channel. Right away, you'll see that I can do some new things. I can sync this entire library, so now we support sync for Microsoft Teams. I can go into a more visual mode by choosing Tiles, which will show me all of the previews, and we support previews of over 330 file types. You can see a couple of them on display here. This is a DICOM images, common in healthcare. This is actually coming through a video file, PDFs, JPEGs, all the Office documents, and even a CAD file is showing us a preview here. Once I start working with these files, if I want to highlight one, I can now pin to top, select a PowerPoint, and have it be the most visible file in this particular view by just pinning it to the top. These are all new capabilities that are actually now fluid and consistent no matter whether you're in SharePoint, OneDrive, Teams, or Outlook. But specifically here, you're getting a much better files experience inside of Teams. One of the things that you want to do to highlight an individual file, and I'll highlight this PowerPoint here, is I right-click and I choose to make this individual file a tab of its own. When I do that, you'll see that it'll load up PowerPoint for the web right here in line so I can do my work. And I can expand this view, and now everybody in this team on this channel can go directly to this individual tab to review the Contoso Loyalty Program PowerPoint, to make changes, to copy and paste from this if they want to share it with other people, or use it when they're in a sales presentation. It's that easy, a single individual file as a tab in Teams. Now, it's important to know that when you're in something like the general channel that I'm in, when we're on the Files tab, that's an individual folder in a much broader document library. And as you're seeing here, we were talking about a single file in that particular folder. But I want to show you how you can bring in the full document library. There's a tab in the plus button where you choose Document Library. And on this particular site, as I click into it, you'll see that it'll give me a list of the different documents and the different libraries that are available in that team site. When I click next, I can name this whatever I want. I'll just do it all docs for visual sake here. And when I click save, this is now going to add that full document library, all of the folders that were in there, now are visible to me on a single tab. So now I can see here's the general channel that we were on, but now I see all the other folders and files that were available in the full document library experience. So let me real quickly show you another way that you can bring in a full document library. This time it's one that's managed at a more parent level across my organization. I go in and choose again Document Library, this time from a SharePoint link. that actually is going to pull in information that's managed by our central marketing group with all of our organization assets. I want to choose the photography folder so that all of my team members have access to all the photos that are available to us to use, like stock photography or approved photography for our different projects. And when I click Save, it's going to go and retrieve that from the intranet. I have permissions to view it here, and I can see that these are now all the photo assets that are available to me to use in my different projects. But as you can see here, I'm still in the Teams user interface on the general channel, now with a new tab called Photos, another way to bring in a full document library of great assets right to my team. SharePoint news, both team-level news and organization news, provide a rich landscape from which to share and learn what's happening throughout your intranet. You can easily create dynamic, media-rich experiences in SharePoint and then have them easily flow into Microsoft Teams. Let's take a closer look across three things you can do with news in Teams. One of the most effective ways to communicate throughout your intranet is using SharePoint News. And we support SharePoint News from the team level, we call that bottoms-up news, and from the organization level, that top-down message to everybody. And I want to show you how you can bring in both team news and org news here in the same view on the general channel as news tabs. It's really easy. You go to the plus button and click on SharePoint, and then this is going to highlight one of the default pages that we create for you, what we call news. I'm going to click it on it. I'm going to post about this down to the channel so I can start a conversation to let people know that news is now available. When I click Save, it brings in this SharePoint page as a beautiful tab in Teams, and it highlights all the news that my team has been publishing, whether it was just a couple of minutes ago or several days and weeks ago. And as I scroll down, you'll see that all the news comes through with beautiful previews, titles, who published it, and when. And click into it, read the news to all my heart's content. So let's switch from talking about team news, where you use the news page from the connected SharePoint team site, to actually pull in organization news that's from the general news portal for the entire company. But we're going to add it here as a tab in Teams. In fact, I've already done that, where if I scroll through and you see org news, as this loads up, I'm going to put it into more of an expansive view. So you can see all the news that's managed from the top down for everybody at the company is right here in line with where me and my team members are working. So as I scroll through, you'll see news from all over the place, from leadership, from the giving campaign, sales and marketing, communications, and it's all laid out beautifully on this organization news page. But really, I've just added it as a page here in Teams so that my team can review all the news, team news and org news, all in one place. Last thing I want to show you is how I can make all the news that my team publishes flow in automatically using a connector that we call SharePoint News Connector. I'm going to go into the general channel again, choose Connectors, and this time I want to go in and search for SharePoint to find the SharePoint News channel, and it's right here at the top, but you can also search for it if you don't see it right away. When I click Configure, what this is going to do is it's going to automatically pull in any published news from the team site and start a conversation directly in our Microsoft Teams chat experience. So that's configured. Now, anytime that I go into my posts and look at the conversations that are happening around me, you'll see here that SharePoint is actually posting news, that the news connector is live, and now any further news that gets published that we saw on the news page will actually automatically start a conversation. Home is where the heart of productivity is, and we love what it can provide to all members of a team. What may have taken 4 to 5 tabs to pull in all the relevant content in context can be simply created as a homepage in SharePoint and then brought in as a single tab in Teams, all on one page. I'll show you how that works. So let's talk about how we can have a combined, very highly contextualized page that will help you put your information in a way that you want to share it in a very rich multimedia way, but also save yourself so you don't have to have 5 or 6 tabs to represent information when you can have it all on one page. So I want to show you how to use your SharePoint team site homepage as a tab in Teams. So I'm going to go in and bring in the homepage using the SharePoint tab. And because we're on the Mark 8 project team, I want to bring in that main homepage. And as this comes in, you'll see that it's going to bring in a lot of information. I'm going to go into a more expanded view so you can see the layout of the entire page. I have a lot of different web parts that I've added to this page. I can see my team calendar here and the team meetings. I can see a snippet of all the news that's going on. I see a countdown to our upcoming product launch in 65 days. But as I scroll the page, you'll see that I've combined a lot of different information coming both from my team and from outside my team, but organized in a way where I want to showcase this almost like a business application to highlight all the pieces of information that are important to my team. But if you remember, I'm in Microsoft Teams in a channel on a single tab. I'm not switching context. I'm not going across different tabs, nor am I leaving the Microsoft Teams interface. I can see conversations that are going on in Yammer. I can see a video, watch it here in line. I can see different activity of what's happening in the site. And as I go further down the page, you can see that I even have some rich experiences of working with documents. I can see analytics that are coming from Power BI, information coming from Twitter, even things that we're using Planner for. I can see the Planner board and all the upcoming tasks that are available to my team. But think about that. You can build out your homepage easily, edit it, add all the web parts that you want, and then bring it as a tab in Teams for a very powerful experience to showcase all that information in the same context. Whether it's a simple list of potential clients to follow up with or a broad laptop asset check-in and check-out business solution, SharePoint lists are the backbone of keeping track of things manually or via workflow and designed with the intent that everyone who views and interacts with that list is in sync with the information and the status that they provide. And even better, you can manage these lists directly next to all the information and conversations you and your team manage. I'll show you how SharePoint lists appear in Teams to give you superpowers to all of your team's data management. To highlight the power of SharePoint lists, I'm going to switch over to a different team that's doing some retail planning, and they have a lot of their information stored in a SharePoint list, and I'm going to bring that in as a tab in Teams and show you the full power of managing data across your team just as another tab in the planning channel here. I'm going to click plus, go to the SharePoint tab, and similar to how we picked pages, you can see I can pivot over to pick lists. The one that I want is the storefront approvals list. As you see, I can bring that in just like any other SharePoint asset in one click. And as it loads up, you'll see that I'm getting access to the full power of the list. Again, I'll go into the expansive view. I can see the information, I can filter it. If I wanted to see all the things that are approved, yes or no, I've actually saved that as a view. So if you know SharePoint lists, I can go to the approved yes. I can switch over, go to outdoors only, and I'm just pivoting the information technically stored in SharePoint, but here for me to access through the Microsoft Teams user interface. Two more things to show you. If I click on an asset, I've actually programmed this as a really nice form that pops up. And you can see that the form pulls through, so I'm here still within Teams. I can read about that single list item. I can make adjustments, make changes however I'd like. I can highlight one list item and see the full set of information on that list and scroll down, see the different activity that have been on this list, who added it last, who maybe made an update or a change. And the last thing, just to prove out that this is a full SharePoint list, for all of you diehard SharePoint list people, I can even go into Quick Edit that keeps me here working productively right in the Microsoft Teams UI, but on the full power of a SharePoint list to manage my data right here in line as a team. SharePoint list as a tab in Teams, it's as easy as that. And that's the design mantra of Microsoft 365, to empower individuals, teams, and organizations to share and work together on content across boundaries, devices, and time. These tips showcase that design integration between two of Microsoft's best-of-class applications, optimized for your content collaboration and sharing of intelligent intranet experiences. And it's all backed by world-class security and compliance to meet the needs of every team across your organization. If your SharePoint site is not yet connected to Microsoft Teams, you can do this very easily right from your team site homepage from the lower left-hand corner. One click. That's the power to teamify your SharePoint site. And with that, cheers and good teamwork to all.